Families, welcome back to the FB First Family Ministry Podcast, where our goal is equipping families to navigate life with God's truth. We got Pastor Gabe on the podcast today, Pastor Jonathan, and we're going to jump into our conversation of the 14 gospel principles that can radically change your family. Man, I sound like I'm on like a... For $16.99,
you can have this product.
For two easy payments of $16.99, you too can have a perfect family.
Hey, man, that's great. Well, here's the thing. Now we know that we're not saying this, right, prophetically, but what I'm saying is if something was ever to happen in your ministry career, calling, profession, job, you know, you can work for, what is it, QVC?
I don't know.
One of those.
I don't know. One of those places. Well, do you know something that I don't? Okay, let's jump into our conversation on grace today. Grace.
Right.
Man, I remember a mentor of mine when I was younger. He told me that grace, he had like a little acrostic for it. It was God's riches at Christ's expense. And, you know, though, you know, it breaks down to some extent, you know, it still rings true the fact that, you know, we do not deserve eternity with God forever in heaven. We do not deserve the grace that God so freely gives to us every single day. Man, we praise him so much for that. And we're talking about extending that grace to our kids today. God, the principle of this one is God never calls you to a task without giving you what you need to do it. He never sends you without going with you.
That's right. And specifically, he's speaking about grace, right?
Yeah.
Parents and Pastor Murdoch, this was probably, I remember when I was reading this book, I got to first read this book before I was having my first son, my only son, but my first child, Zurek. And as I was preparing, as I was trying to prepare to be a dad, I read this chapter in this book in the chapter, and this probably changed my worldview in such a good way.
Because
as Paul Tripps tackled the grace that we show our children, he first does so by helping you understand as an adult that you first need to have a healthy view of the grace that you are given, have been given, and will be given.
Come on.
And that just changes the game as a parent.
Twists and turns, following Jesus changes the game. Man, I'm having VBS flashbacks right now. Parents, if you're listening to this with your kids have just now got this song stuck in their head for the rest of the week, and you too. You're welcome for that. Yes, no, absolutely. Well, no, and God's grace is so much, like, we all need God's grace. You know, we can't do without God's grace. You know, God gave his grace freely to us. We didn't deserve it. It wasn't free for him. He paid the ultimate price. Jesus paid the ultimate price, but we don't have to do anything. We can't do anything to receive God's grace, but he gives it to us anyways. And man, what a testimony that we get to share with our families and with our children.
Yeah, no, and the thing that we need to, as we're thinking about grace, and you, parent, as you're thinking about grace, look, we're not perfect, right? Parent.
I feel like we say that on every podcast.
Reminder, you are not perfect. Actually, I use the pronoun we are not perfect. but believe it or not, it is such an important thing to be reminded of, because I think sometimes we try to pursue things in perfection, and not that we don't want to be a good steward and be faithful in what we're doing, but we try to be perfect, and man, the fact that we need grace is proof that we are not perfect, and that's why we need grace. And one of the things that I love Paul Tripp talking about is that not only do we need to understand the grace that we have been shown in the past through Jesus Christ, not only do we need to understand the grace that we'll be shown in the future, but we need to understand the grace that we are showing today. And as parents, look, there is no perfect handbook out there for how to be a parent. I mean, there's just not. If there was, it would be one of the most bestseller books in the world for parents. And there's a million books out there, but there's not one perfect book. But there are some very perfect principles. And in this case, is this, to me, is this principle of grace, of truth that, man, like, no, I cannot do it by myself. No, at the end of the day, even though I try as hard as I can, I'm not going to be able to be the perfect parent.
Yeah.
And guess what? That's okay. Because here's the beauty, that whenever we understand that sometimes God calls those who are not able, he does so that way we can search for help, and that ultimately, by searching for help, we can find the helper.
Yeah.
And that being him.
That's Christ. That's Christ right there. You know, I was thinking when you were like, I have these, you know, pictures that just come in my head, these stories, you know, and whenever you said, you know, if there was a book just about parenting, that was like how to have a perfect child in 10 days.
Yeah.
It's like, oh man, how to have the perfect family. Listen, 10 steps to your... How many books are there, though? I mean, I feel like they're everywhere.
Now, and by the way, let me say this. The best book you can have as a parent is the Bible. You have all the principles. That is a perfect... Right again, I'm talking about practical... And although, yes, the Bible is also practical, actually.
Yeah,
you
absolutely.
Know what? I'm going to stop because I'm going to keep myself...
You're talking about non-inspired works.
Yeah, correct. Yeah, I'm talking about just humanly self-centered books. Like, we know there's no, like, you know, here's the way to change the perfect diaper. It's just... that's just not. But you know, it's one of those things where, man, as I think about being a father and... What does this like? How does grace look practically in my life? And here's where it gets hard. And here's probably why I love this so much. It's because, yes, I'm not perfect and I'm not the best father. I'm not the best parent, although I try to pursue faithfully what God has called me to. The way that looks like oftentimes is by having the hard assessment of, you know, does the things that I say and do they tell more about my kids or do they tell more about me? You know, is my bad attitude, are my bad actions, are my bad even words, are they really just, oh, well, my child made me do these things? Or is it really more about, well, actually, this is what was in my heart and it just came out because your child happened to be the catalyst that was used to get those things out there. But in essence, was it really your child or was it really you?
Right.
And
right.
Guess what? I'm not the perfect parent. So there's been things that I've done that I'm not very proud of. And at that moment, I cannot blame my child, although I try to, trust me, in my mind, logically, I try to do that. But I'm reminded that, hey, man, this is me.
Yeah.
I'm the one that did those things and I didn't do it right. And man, I'm just a failure. Well, guess what? God's grace.
Right.
God's grace at that moment.
You know that you remember this the hymn, Your Grace Still Amazes Me, Your Love Still a Mystery. I love that song so much because, and it says, each day I fall on my knees because your grace still amazes me. God's grace should amaze us, and that amazement of his grace should cause us then to show grace to our kids. So. Man, I've just really enjoyed this episode of the Family Ministry Podcast. We are closing another episode, but listen, it doesn't stop here. We release two of these every single month. We want you to join us next month. We're going to talk again about the 14 Gospel Parenting Principles. If you haven't got the book yet, make sure you get it. We'll talk to you later and have a great one, parents. See ya.